This episode of Weekly Weird News is sponsored by ExpressVPN and by Bespoke Post.
Oh my god, it happened again. So you'll recall back in 2012, a fresco painting of the Lord Jesus Christ in a church in Spain was restored by a local elderly woman turning this into this.
When did this become this?
2012.
Yeah.
So while at first glance you'd be forgiven for assuming this was an act of intentional vandalism, it was in fact an act of good faith art restoration gone wrong. The old woman just didn't know what the hell she was doing, and presumably her eyesight wasn't so good, because just look at it.
Yeah, but good intentions nonetheless.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nothing malicious. So news about what had happened here, it spread like wildfire across the internet. People just couldn't get enough of it. It was mocked mercilessly. It was given names like the Monkey Christ and Potato Jesus.
Yeah.
And we all had a good laugh, but on the bright side of things, this extremely botched art restoration led to a massive increase of tourism to the town of Borja, because people just really wanted to see this thing up close, in person, in all of its glory.
Yeah, it really turned into its own piece of art. And, you know, bless that woman's heart, she took everyone's attention away from Coney 2012 and onto this abomination.
Monkey 2012.
Yeah. In the years that have followed, a strange trend has emerged. Maybe we're just becoming more aware of it now.
Yeah.
This is all specifically in Spain, and that's various old works of art being restored by amateurs and made to look much worse than before. There was this statue of St. George, which was definitely in need of a serious touch-up, but came out looking like it belonged on a carnival merry-go-round. There was this wooden statue of Jesus and Mary, which looked perfectly fine aside from maybe needing a bit of cleaning and a new layer of varnish, but it was instead painted over in the most bright and obnoxious colors possible. And then there was this painting of Mary that was restored horribly, then came out even worse than before that they tried to fix it with the restoration, leading to calls for new regulation by Spain's professional art restoration community.
This has gone too far.
Wasn't there also the football player that was like, he's like, I've never done a cast like this before, but I'll give it a go.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about the Cristiano Ronaldo bronze statue.
It wasn't a restoration. It was an original. But I guess the person had never worked in, like, bronze before, so the mold shrunk weird.
And that was Portugal.
Oh, okay.
Different country. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, they're neighbors. So
they're right there.
It makes sense that there'd be some, you know, cross-cultural exchange about how to fuck up art.
Yes.
Anyway, folks, it has happened again. In the city of Palencia, Spain, the sculpted facade of a nearly 100-year-old bank was recently fixed, with this smiling woman's head replaced with this utter abomination.
I love it so much.
And the face they chose is oddly reminiscent of the Jesus painting that kicked off this horrible trend 8 years ago, which, that's nice, full circle.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's just three holes for the eyes and the mouth and then a slight protrusion suggesting a nose.
Mm.
They even seem to have mangled the woman's headscarf somehow. All you had to do was it's a headscarf. It's not complicated. What's interesting in this case, though, is that it's unclear how long the sculpture has even looked like this. It's five stories above ground, and as you can see from Google Street View, you can barely see it from the ground level without binoculars or a telephoto lens. You got to really be looking for it.
Yeah.
And that's probably why whoever was in charge of fixing it didn't even bother putting too much effort into it. I mean, who's going to notice?
Yeah.
Whatever. It's all the way up here.
It's fine.
Yeah. Well, now everyone has noticed, and Spain's professional art restoration community is, again, pretty upset. With their official trade group Twitter account replying to all sorts of posts about this all over Twitter in an effort to make sure that everyone knows that they had nothing to do with it, guys.
Guys, we've been repairing the way people view us for years now. I just imagine the frustration when this broke. They were just like, we've worked so hard to change people's minds.
And it just keeps happening, specifically in Spain.
Mm-hmm.
It's weird.
Yeah.
Because I was looking into this. I took a deep dive. I'm like, let's see if we can find more examples from throughout the world. And there's like a handful, but most of them are in Spain.
Yeah. Yeah.
Everyone in Spain just thinks they can restore art. Like, how hard could it be?
The last time we went over this, too, we suggested that maybe the success of the first one in boosting tourism had a little bit to do with...
Maybe our town needs a ugly piece of shit.
Yeah, a facelift. Yeah. Anyways.
Diminishing returns.
Speaking of expectation versus reality, though, we recently talked about how Concordia University of Ann Arbor had a bunch of apparently bot-generated merchandise show up on apparel websites where it was not listed as Concordia University of Ann Arbor, but rather Concordia University of Michigan. This resulted in a whole lot of merchandise with the word cum on it. Cum hats, cum shirts, cum shorts, cum hoodies, you name it.
Cum!
Just a massive line of apparel for all the cum lovers out there. Now, when we first talked about this a few weeks back, a discussion of the Concordia University merch store had finally reached a point where the actual university was aware of it, as was the website selling all the cum merch, and the merch listings were in the process of gradually being switched from cum to just CU.
Coo.
But we wondered, had anyone managed to place orders before the fix? And if they did, would their cum merch be showing up as advertised?
And yeah, the answer is yes. Turns out a bunch of people jumped at the opportunity to own some cum merch, and they got it. Mm-hmm. The cum heart design was quite popular, as was the I heart cum design, and of course the cum XXL. Definitely a big seller there. These rare limited edition merch, this merch drop. Was only available for a brief moment in time.
It's like a Supreme drop.
Yeah.
Yeah, real hype beast shit.
Yeah, it's an unintentional Supreme. Mm-hmm. But yeah, now a lot of people own official cum merchandise.
Which I'm sure they're wearing everywhere in real life and not just taking pictures of it for the internet.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's not like they'd be going all that many places anyway.
True, yeah.
You're only really dressing up for yourself these days.
Yeah, for the Zoom call.
Yeah.
Doing it for the Zoom.
Yeah. Unfortunately, at least one of our viewers who tried to get their hands on some cum merch did so a bit too late. They dropped $75 on a cum heart sweatshirt only to receive this bullshit CU heart sweatshirt instead.
Sad.
Hopefully there's a good return policy on all this because it's clearly not what
was ordered. Yeah, I would immediately send it back. Yeah, this is false advertising. Take it back.
Yeah, you only
gave
me
a pretty open
two out of the three letters I was promised.
Mm-hmm. Oh, well. Yeah. Stitch an M on there.
I am.
Send me the M.
I didn't see... I'm disappointed that no one that I could find bought the cum hat, my favorite part of it.
Ah, okay.
The red cum hat is just... I don't know why. It makes me laugh.
We've said this before. The problem with any red hat, regardless of what it says on it, is that from a distance of 20 feet or more, you look like a MAGA supporter.
Yeah. But this one, when you get closer, it says cum.
It says cum instead, yeah.
Classic.
Hey, you! Oh, never mind.
That's hilarious.
Yeah.
You got cum on your head.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of oopsies, though, Amazon recently got itself into a bit of an international incident thanks to some interactions its Amazon Help account had on Twitter. Amazon's Prime Video service includes additional offerings for live sporting events, but some Prime users in Northern Ireland tweeted at Amazon expressing frustration about not being able to watch this weekend's Rugby Autumn Nations Cup. After a long back and forth, Amazon Help said the following, quote, "Thank you for that information. We apologize, but upon reviewing your location, you're in Northern Ireland. Rugby Autumn Nations Cup coverage is exclusively available to Prime members based in the UK. We don't have the rights to other territories."
Now, if you're not from the UK or Ireland, you may not have noticed anything out of the ordinary up there. But Northern Ireland is, in fact, a part of the United Kingdom, and that's pretty controversial for a lot of people out there. Mm-hmm. Maybe less so now than 40 years ago, but it's still a hot button issue. There's the Republic of Ireland that covers the bottom 80% or so of the island of Ireland, and that's its own country. Mm-hmm. But Northern Ireland is not part of the Republic of Ireland because it's part of the UK. And we have neither the time nor the expertise to explain how exactly this current Ireland situation came to be, but basically, the UK used to control all of Ireland, and then around 100 years ago, there was the Irish War of Independence, and in the end of that war, the UK gave up most of its Irish territory, but they kept the section now known as Northern Ireland. This, however, did not end the Irish nationalist movement, which still saw Northern Ireland as occupied territory, and later in the 20th century, there was what was known as the Troubles, which
such
is
a fun way
of describing decades of violence between nationalists and loyalists.
It
in
sounds
and around
like
Northern
people
Ireland.
Had diarrhea there.
A bit of the old Troubles.
We had some of the Troubles. Very bad.
It was bad. It was a bad time. Mm-hmm. It's incredible how far things have come.
Yes,
but yeah, the Troubles. really underselling it.
I had a couple of tacos last night, and I woke up and had a case of the troubles this morning.
A little tummy trouble?
Yeah.
Well, no, there wasn't a fucking bomb in my stomach, so.
Yeah.
No. I wouldn't call them troubles. Mm. But anyway, the troubles pretty much officially came to an end in 1998 with the Good Friday Agreement, which I can't even begin to explain, but it was basically a treaty that did a bunch of stuff. I'm not even going to pretend to know what it is, but it stopped the troubles for the most part.
Until now.
Until now. They're back.
The troubles are back.
Jeff Bezos is bringing that back.
Yeah, it's all still a very sore subject for a lot of people in the Republic of Ireland, Northern Ireland, and elsewhere in the United Kingdom. So Amazon publicly asserting that Northern Ireland is not a part of the UK, that attracted a lot of attention. And with whoever was running the Amazon help account seemingly oblivious to what they had just done, how dare you? The tweets just kept on coming.
Yeah.
Someone responded to that previous tweet with, Northern Ireland is part of the UK. And Amazon help replied, many apologies, but we don't have the broadcast rights for Ireland or other territories. Guys, sorry. So now not only is Northern Ireland not part of the UK, it's officially part of Ireland.
32 counties, baby. 26 plus 6 equals 1.
All because of Bezos.
Yep.
Adding to the awkwardness of all this, in a completely separate exchange with a user in the Republic of Ireland asking about how to watch a rugby match, Amazon began its reply with, hi there, we apologize for the troubles.
Jesus Christ.
The new troubles they're talking about. The troubles we caused.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why? What is the trouble? It's probably someone in fucking Pakistan or something.
Yeah.
Apologize for the... What did I say? What did I say?
Yeah. It's like everyone's looking at Facebook. Facebook's the Trojan horse, and Amazon's walking out the back. Mm-hmm. Just like, you thought your country was going to get torn down by Facebook.
Nope.
But no, it was Amazon the whole time. And it all came down to sporting broadcast rights.
Yeah.
Which is a huge deal everywhere but America.
I wonder if they have Amazon in Palestine. Those people need special training to answer any tweets.
Well, it's like here in America, Amazon gets the rights to Thursday Night Football, and I think for the most part, everyone in America is just like, whatever, have it. We're not going to watch.
Yeah.
We don't care. Football kind of sucks. No one's really watching it anymore.
Tom
Brady's on the Bucks. Who gives a shit anymore?
Who gives a shit?
The good thing this year, though, is I think a lot of the bad teams are doing well, which is kind of fun to watch.
That's fun.
I got to wait till 2022 to watch my XFL, though. The real sport.
You get another chance. Anyway, the fun didn't stop there. Someone jumped into that first thread and wrote, thank you, comrade Amazon help. And Amazon responded, you're welcome. Do keep us posted for any further concerns. Someone else wrote, hi, Amazon help. It's the 6 northern eastern counties of Ireland here. We were automatically signed up for membership of the UK 100 years ago and can't find the link to cancel. Can you help? And Amazon replied with a helpful link to do that.
Yeah.
And someone else asked, I ordered 32 counties for next day delivery, and it's coming up on 100 years of partition. Can I get a refund? To which Amazon replied, thanks for contacting us. Tell us more. We understand Northern Ireland is part of the UK with regard to Amazon Video. How can we help you? Let us know.
Oh, the Amazon help is learning.
Like, okay, yes. In regards to, it's part of the UK. Yeah, for the package deal, yes.
Yeah.
But officially, it's Amazon official policy.
I feel like
Ireland is a sovereign nation.
I feel like Amazon UK is like the help is like an AI Tay situation.
Yeah.
Where it's just going to become extremely racist.
Well, I think I don't even know if these are real people, but yeah, it could be an AI thing where it was just trained that Ireland is Ireland. And like what?
Or it's someone in a call center that has like 50 prompts and they just have to click one.
Yeah.
And it's like a Mad Libs.
Northern Ireland, yeah. Southern Ireland, who gives a shit?
Look, I can't.
Why are you being so specific?
I'm one person in a call center. I can't give you the rights to watch rugby.
Yeah.
That's what we're getting to here. It's a bigger deal than you know. It's bigger than both of us.
But Amazon asked to learn more, and that person then replied, you want to know more about the partition of Ireland? Okay, but this is going to be a long thread. So after Brian Boru's spheric victory over the Vikings at the Battle of Clontarf in 1014, tweet 1 of 800.
Fantastic. This international incident, of course, inspired some memes. Here's the iconic, you are now entering free dairy sign. It was changed to, you are now entering free delivery. Here's someone saying, come out ye package fans, a pun on the old Irish rebel song, come out ye black and tans. And there were jokes about Amazon's customer service team being either these masked IRA members or this man, former Sinn Féin president Gerry Adams. And luckily, we're at a point in history where all sides of Ireland, of the Ireland issue, seem to have enjoyed a good laugh about this misunderstanding, which is probably not something you would have seen just 25 short years ago.
Yeah, no, it's, I mean, it's a tense situation. It seems that time has healed a lot of wounds there. When you go into Belfast, it's still pretty striking that, like, they got all those big-ass murals on there about, like, this is our guy who died in a hunger strike, and then you go through the Protestant neighborhoods, and they got their own murals and shit, but,
I don't know, with Amazon dropping the whole Troubles thing, if I was in Ireland and I saw an Amazon truck crossing the street,
yeah,
get away.
Yeah.
I'm not saying anything that's good. It's just a joke. It's a joke.
Yeah. Also, if you're ever in Ireland and you go to a bar, don't order an Irish car bomb. Whatever you do.
And don't order it here either.
Yeah. It's just, it's not a... Also, it's disgusting.
Yeah,
you got a shot of Irish cream in a beer? What are you... It's gross.
It's also very unfortunately the name.
Yeah.
It's one of those things that when I was literally 22, I was like, awesome. That sounds awesome.
Yeah.
Sounds like a real cool guy.
Irish car bomb. What's that named after?
You had no idea.
Oh. Oh. What? Ireland, the place with the leprechauns, they
went through the troubles?
They've had a civil war for the last century? Well, shit.
Yeah, what's fucked up about that is I was like, I was ordering these within 10 years of Good Friday.
Yeah.
Like, no time had passed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's mm-hmm. America.
Yeah. It's like if Germany or something had a widely popular mixed drink that was named after 9/11.
Yeah. Maybe there should be, just you know, to make things fair.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
If we're allowed to be ignorant as fuck about everyone else in the world,
they can do it to us.
They can do it to us.
Sure.
Yeah. Anyways, before we get to this week's headlines, this episode is sponsored by ExpressVPN. We talk a lot about how social media companies mainly exist to just harvest your data, and that's it. And if you've been watching a lot of Netflix lately, you may have seen a documentary called The Social Dilemma, which features tech insiders explaining how social media is engineered to exploit users' data for profit in what they call surveillance capitalism. Now, say what you will about the normal capitalism that we all live under, but at least you're a willing participant in the transaction. Like, you know, you go to the store and you exchange money for food. Mm-hmm. Beep, bop, boop. When it's your data being harvested so tech billionaire ghouls can get even more obscenely rich than they already are, that's where we gotta really draw the line, folks. And thankfully, with ExpressVPN, we've got a layer of protection around our data.
Or you could say that you're not in Northern Ireland.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Amazon.
Yeah. Every time you use the internet, big tech companies, they mine your data by tracking your searches, messages, and video history. But when you run ExpressVPN on your device, it hides your IP address, which websites use to personally identify you. That makes your activity more difficult to trace and sell to advertisers. You still need to be careful with what you share on social media, but ExpressVPN can make your web browsing more anonymous. ExpressVPN also encrypts 100% of your internet data to keep you safe from hackers and prying eyes. Many VPNs, they slow down your internet, but not ExpressVPN. It's incredibly fast, it's easy to use, you just tap one button and you're protected. So if you don't like the idea of tech companies exploiting your personal information, visit expressvpn.com/weeklyweird right now and you can get 3 extra months of ExpressVPN for free. That is expressvpn.com/weeklyweird to protect your data. Go to expressvpn.com/weeklyweird to learn more.
And this episode is sponsored by Bespoke Post. This fall, as you get back into the swing of things, Bespoke Post has brand new seasonal box of awesome collections for guys and folks who like guy stuff, guaranteed to upgrade your life. They got boxes that especially appeal to us. There's a barrel aging kit for booze, a cocktail kit, a very fancy looking one-hitter kit for consuming legal flowered substances only.
Duh, it's like when I found my dad's tools in the 90s. Mm-hmm. Those are your father's tools. Put them away.
But kits also range from travel accessories to tools to hygiene products and more. Whether it's gear to upgrade your autumn craft beers or cozy threads for when the temperature dips, Bespoke Post only sends the best stuff every month. No matter what you're into, Box of Awesome has you covered. From style and grooming goods to barware, cooking tools, and outdoor gear, Box of Awesome has collections for every part of your life.
The best part of this is just, you know, we're going to be in this lockdown for a while still. It's nice to have something show up and open it up. Yeah. It's like a present for yourself.
Yeah.
You don't know what you're going to get. Pop it open.
You can be your own secret Santa.
It really helps in times like these. Mm-hmm. Here's another great box that looks pretty useful as things get colder. The Stocked Box, with all the medicine essentials you'll need in case you start feeling under the weather for a great price. Listen, to get started, take the quiz at boxofawesome.com. Your answers will help them pick the right Box of Awesome for you. They release new boxes every month across a ton of different categories. It's free to sign up. You can skip a month or cancel at any time. Each box costs $45, but there's over $70 worth of gear inside. Get 20% off your first monthly box when you sign up at boxofawesome.com and enter the code WEIRD at checkout. That is boxofawesome.com, code WEIRD, for 20% off your first box. Get yourself a birthday present every month.
Now on to the headlines, starting with the best headline I've seen in a long time. Mm. Trump's ex-attorney, Michael Cohen, makes his debut on OnlyFans with gay adult film star.
So his book obviously isn't doing very well.
No, Michael Cohen is not showing hog on OnlyFans. He got tricked. Mm. He has a Cameo account.
People love tricking people on Cameo.
An OnlyFans, a male, I don't know if it's for the ladies or for the guys or for both, but a man with an OnlyFans account paid Michael Cohen to say nice things about him. And Michael Cohen apparently does not know what OnlyFans is. Because he was just throwing that out there. He's like, we love what you're all doing there over at OnlyFans. It's great stuff. You know, happy to be a part of it.
Yeah.
Let me just show you the video.
Yeah.
Here you go.
Matthew Camp, Michael Cohen here, former personal attorney to President Donald J. Trump, now actually going to be former President Donald J. Trump. Listen, I just want to say how amazing Matthew Camp is on OnlyFans. Having a blast, enjoying every minute with you guys. Good luck. Love it. Stay safe. Stay COVID-free. And again, OnlyFans, having a blast with them. Enjoy.
So there you go.
There you go, yeah.
Yeah.
We've been cooking up an idea, but it's a little expensive, so us and our friends have to come together for it. But it's Steve Harvey is now on Cameo, and we're going to try to get him to endorse the runoff Senate candidates in Georgia, inadvertently. Jordan got Rachel Dolezal to endorse Joe Biden and Kamala Harris on Cameo. So anything's possible. People on there, they got like 50 scripts a day. They're just like, yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
Give it to me.
Wonder how many votes Rachel Dolezal cost the Democrats.
Probably a lot.
Yeah.
But Steve Harvey's like $300. It's going to take a little saving.
Yeah. I mean, just pass the cup around. You got yourself a Steve Harvey Cameo.
Yeah. Anyways, let's move on. Voter fraud caught again in Bird of the Year competition.
We just can't have democracy anymore. Not even in lowly... apparently, us... New Zealand just has an annual Bird of the Year.
Why not?
It's not like they're...
The Kiwi wins again.
Well, yeah, this was a bunch of fraudulent votes for a specific type of Kiwi. I think the spotted Kiwi. It's one that's pretty endangered.
Why did it need the fraudulent votes? Couldn't it win on its own?
No, not in nature and not in this bird election.
The dodo bird wins again.
But like, I don't know. The bird situation in New Zealand, it can't change that much from year to year. How's the... Why are they holding a Bird of the Year competition every year?
Because they're fun people.
Yeah, they are.
They like doing things.
Also, it's funny that the only animals, they don't have land animals. They just have birds. And because they don't have land animals...
They don't have sheep?
They were brought there.
Yeah, oh, okay. Yeah.
Like, native. They don't have any land mammals or anything.
Dragons.
I think they might have reptiles, but yeah, it was like just birds. But because it was just birds, you get a whole range. Like... Up until a few hundred years ago, they had the moa, which is the most terrifying fucking animal that's ever existed. The Maori killed them all in self-defense. But yeah, it was basically a modern dinosaur. You go to the museum there, they got a bunch of them stuffed. And it's just like, you run into one of these things, you're fucking dead.
But don't try to go see a kiwi there. We've been over this. They don't come out in the daytime.
Yeah, you gotta
go see a stuffed one.
You can only see them in like, these shadow boxes, basically, because they're nocturnal. Mm-hmm. But yeah, a lot of different birds, and they love all of them.
They love them so much, they got to get... It's like an employee of the month over there in New Zealand.
Yeah.
Well, good for them.
Great tits could be wiped out by climate change in the near future.
And SJWs.
Yeah.
This is
bird news, okay. Yeah. But yeah, there's a bird called the Great Tit. And if you like tits, well...
Buddy,
climate change, it's coming for them. After climate change hits, it's only going to be bad tits. Just irregular,
the worst tits.
Asymmetrical tits.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You hate to see it.
You're not going to like the tits that's around once the earth gets too hot. So fix your shit.
We used to have wonderful tits here on Earth.
We used to have great tits.
Look
what happened.
The best tits.
All of our tits are fucking terrible now.
Yeah. Much like New Zealand, America has a Greatest Tits Award that they give out every year. Completely different, though.
Greatest tit.
Yeah.
Why are all you ladies taking your shirts off? No, yeah. This is a bird competition, but we're glad you're here.
No, I was talking about the one at Sturgis.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, a woman arrested for impersonating FBI agent to get free Chick-fil-A.
I love this plan because it's...
Pretty good.
The logic is just like... Like, hello, I'm an FBI agent, so as you know, the FBI...
We eat for free.
We eat for free at all Chick-fil-A locations. We have a deal with the guy in charge. So,
yeah.
Yeah, I'll have a spicy sandwich and, waffle fries, of course.
First of all, extra dip. Ma'am, thank you for your service.
Yeah.
Second of all, here you go.
Yeah.
She probably got away with it a few times, I'm sure.
No, she tried it multiple times in the course of a few days. And finally, like the Chick-fil-A, it sounded like they kept being like, no. And she'd be like, listen, if you don't give me that food for free, I'm going to call up,
James Comey.
Call my bosses at the FBI and you're going to have some trouble. Even when the cops eventually were called, she pretended to talk into a little radio that didn't exist in her jacket. She's they're arresting me. We're going to need you to come down here and sort things out.
You got to give it to her for committing to the bit.
Yeah, she wanted that free Chick-fil-A.
She never at one point was just like, all right, you got me. I'm impersonating an FBI agent. Yeah. I'm actually just crazy.
Yeah, I'm just really hungry.
I'm a very hungry person.
Chick-fil-A, you'll break the law.
It's so damn good.
Get your mouth around one of them sandwiches. Mm-hmm. French school asked parents to stop throwing children over the fence when they're late.
What? Here you go.
Yeah, I guess they lock the gate after a certain point because, you know, you're supposed to get to school on time. And this fence, it's like 1.8 meters, so about 6 feet high.
That's not that high.
And parents will just come and they're like, all right, you're not late. Run along.
Just land on your backpack.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And they posted this amazing flyer on their gate asking parents not to do it. It's just, I don't know where they found this graphic of throwing a kid over a fence. It's a custom job.
It's great.
Yeah.
They need to build a moat.
Yeah.
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 Still somehow less dangerous than American schools.
Yeah. I mean, this is the worst thing that can happen in a French elementary school. You get a couple bruises from getting thrown over the fence.
Builds character.
By your shitty dad who didn't leave the house on time. That's mm-hmm. fine. Better than a bullet.
Yeah. Microsoft. Please don't blow vape smoke into your Xbox Series X.
Yeah, so the first day it came out, there was all those videos like, oh, it's already breaking down. Look, it's got smoke coming out. But it's because people were blowing vape smoke into the air intake in the back. Mm-hmm. And then you turn it on and the fan blows. It was very funny. So a lot of people kept doing it. And then the Xbox fanboys were like, no, you're making them look bad. Like, we need all the support we can get right now during this console war.
I mean, if I was like an investor in Microsoft or something, I'd be like, hey, can you knock it off? This isn't real. But you're going to trick people into thinking it is.
Yeah.
Like, we all saw how stupid the stock market was this week with the Beyond Meat thing.
The stock market is, it's astrology for men.
I honestly think that, like, Robinhood
has ruined,
it,
like,
literally, the stability.
An institution that's been around for, like, hundreds of years.
Yeah, we used to do, like, you know, we used to follow more closely that millennials killed this kind of...
Millennials actually
they
did kill
the stock market. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it doesn't make any fucking sense.
They didn't kill it. They just...
Memified
They ruined it. They changed it.
I just imagine, like, an old stock trader who's, like, just trying to make sense of anything
the fuck
these days.
Yeah.
It was like when, at the beginning of the pandemic, when, like, some stock that had absolutely nothing to do with Zoom, the video conferencing, like, they were just, like, shot up. We're all trillionaires!
Yeah.
For no reason.
Yeah. This console war, I'm excited.
It looks like PlayStation has had way less trouble getting consoles to people.
Yeah.
Whereas Xbox is just like, look, I mean, these are... Made in America, baby. They take a little bit longer.
Listen, buddy, Halo doesn't come out for like 6 months.
Yeah, what's the point? Yeah. Everything's on the cloud anyway.
Yeah.
PlayStation 5's got the bug snacks and the miles.
I hope Naruto comes back. Because I just remembered back in the day, like 2014-ish.
PS4 was better.
Every YouTube comment section was full of anime avatars just being like, ha ha ha, the Xbox is the best console, you idiots. And then just a bunch of children, like obviously actual fucking children would be like, no, you're wrong, Naruto. The PlayStation 4 is your best. And just be these giant chains of arguments. And it's like just the most obvious bait, but it worked.
I miss the old YouTube.
I want Naruto back.
It was very annoying at the time.
Yeah, I was just like, what the fuck is...
but I did
I banned so many Naruto accounts. They just kept popping up.
Yeah. I wish if we still had access to the old ETC account, we could like look at the banned user list. Yeah. And it would be at least a dozen Narutos.
Yeah.
Yeah. Florida's DeSantis moves to allow citizens to shoot looters and rioters targeting businesses.
What could go wrong?
Yeah, it's almost as if this could backfire. The whole thing is very intentional, but also could backfire very easily.
This is a state.
Also, you can hit people with your cars.
Yeah.
If they're blocking the road.
So just imagine thousands of George Zimmermans all in one place at one time. Mm-hmm. What could go wrong?
Yeah. And the probable cause rests on the eyewitnesses, too. Just like, he was stealing, so that guy murdered him.
Yeah, luckily, it sounds like he's getting some pretty strong pushback from, like, Miami-Dade County, where they're just like, yeah, this is, down here in Miami-Dade, we don't think that possible alleged property crime should
a death sentence?
Be an immediate death sentence from vigilantes. Yeah, we're going to push back on this.
This is like on the heels of him also making it a felony to essentially participate in protests.
Wait.
Because if the protest turns violent.
Oh, so, yeah.
But basically, okay. If you're just there protesting and like a bad faith actor comes up and throws like a tear gas thing and then it causes some chaos, if you get arrested near that, that's a felony. You can't you can't do a lot of things with a felony, including live a normal life, get a job, own a home.
Very cool.
Vote in some states, get on an airplane sometimes, leave the country, whatever, just because you were at a protest. So it's DeSantis is really coming down on the whole
fascism?
Yeah.
Just being a fascist?
He's doing a fascism. Yeah.
Speaking of shooting, gun stocks tumble after upbeat vaccine news. Lack of civil unrest.
Amazing.
Man, I had so many option plays set up for when the world went to shit. I was going to fucking make bank.
Yeah. Plywood distributors in shambles.
Yeah, big plywood.
Big plywood is suffering. There you go.
What a country. Mm-hmm. New Jersey governor pleads with COVID-fatigued residents to choose inconvenience over death. Quote, you know what's really uncomfortable and annoying? When you die, a blunt Governor Phil Murphy said.
Yeah, finally a lot of, even in red states, the governors and mayors are just like, all right, guys, things are getting a little out of control.
Yeah, they're finally, like,
Utah just shut down or did a they did a permanent mask mandate for now.
Because this shit's out of hand.
Yeah.
It is way out of hand.
Yeah.
And it's way out of hand, mostly in the places that have been just haven't done shit about it.
El Paso tried to pass a thing where they would go back under lockdown and like the governor of Texas was like, nope. Meanwhile, there's like videos of like multiple refrigerated semi-truck trailers being filled with bodies by inmates.
Oh, yeah.
Because the nurses and doctors are all on call. So they're getting inmates to load bodies into refrigerated trucks.
Not dystopian at all.
No.
No.
This is exactly the future we all imagined.
Yeah, I'm waiting for American politicians have still not reached the level of like Italian politicians back in like March and April.
Mm-hmm.
I think John Oliver featured a bunch
just
of
like
videos of them
yelling
just
at people.
Yelling at people, just mm-hmm. personally going out and
oh, no. No, our politicians are complete assholes.
They're cucked.
And oddly enough, the people who by all accounts should be the ones being careful are doing the worst stuff out of all of them. Fucking Nancy Pelosi trying
oh my
to host
God.
That dinner. Gavin Newsom going to a Michelin star restaurant with like 13 people. Like what are you doing? You dumb fuck. Like,
yeah.
Like we all know that you're a piece of shit, but like, do you really got to do this? You got to like show how much of a piece of shit you are every
yeah.
single opportunity that you have.
Yeah, that congressional like dinner thing. It's just like
it's fine.
Oh, we're testing everyone. We're doing a
the
rapid
tables
test.
Are separated, and it's like you look. The picture of the dining room was just yeah. like
looks like any. No indication there's a pandemic. Though.
Not just that, but it looks like they're eating in a golden palace
yeah.
while people are starving and wondering if they're going to keep their apartments in a month.
Yeah, it's
like it's insane. No one thinks about optics apparently. Like, they're just like, well, okay, but we're... No, you don't understand. We're social distancing the tables. What about the optics, Nancy?
This is what guillotines are for. Sorry, pictures of guillotines on Twitter.
In a video game.
Speaking of Italy,
yeah.
Italian police use Lamborghini Huracan to transport kidney 300 miles in just 2 hours.
Hell yeah.
That's so fucking fast.
That's awesome.
But yeah, it's safer than that helicopter. That
yeah,
we talked
exactly.
about a couple days ago where, if you missed it, a helicopter bringing a heart to USC... crashed.
Just everyone lived.
Crashed. Everyone was fine though. But then they picked up the cooler with the heart and then spilled it and dropped it on the ground.
And then a dog ate it.
That didn't happen.
No, the guy got the heart transplant.
It was a series of unfortunate events. So over in Italy,
yeah,
it's just like, yeah, fuck it. Just fire up the old official police Lamborghini
what?
That has a built-in like freezer specifically for organ transportation.
Probably in the front too.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah,
because that's where the trunk is.
Mm-hmm.
The engine's in the back.
Yeah. Yeah,
300 miles.
Really cool doing it, too.
300 miles in 2 hours is insane.
Yeah. Insane. Average speed of 150 miles
yeah.
an hour. Just crazy.
Hey, they got it done.
Yeah. Yeah. I love it. So-called fight club at McGill University really happened, and students say COVID life is to blame. What were we supposed to do?
I mean, I get it.
Mm-hmm.
So McGill University only has dorms for freshmen, so their on-campus life has got to be just fucking bonkers in any given year, mm-hmm. but this year especially, because it's Canada, so as an 18-year-old, you'd usually be able to, like, actually go out to bars and shit. Not this year.
I bet they're hockey players.
A couple of hockey players started a fight club the other day.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just dudes. It was an actual fucking fight club, which is funny, because I remember in, like, the early 2000s, after Fight Club came out.
Oh, there was, like, fight clubs in high school.
Teenagers and shit, they would always, like, oh, let's start a fight club. But it would last, like, one attempt and be like, yeah. Wow, that was stupid.
Yeah, nobody actually wanted to fight. It was, like, the crazy kids did.
Yeah.
And everyone else was just like, wait, hold on, now I got to fight? Nah, never coming back to this.
But yeah, this was apparently a real thing.
Yeah. There you go.
That's what young people do.
One of the side effects of COVID.
Yep.
Another new comorbidity.
Yep.
Fight clubs.
Twitch streamers report DMCA takedowns for in-game sound effects.
I love that the marketing people are actually getting upset by this now. Like, the people that are trying to market games are just like, we're having to, like, first of all, people are scared to play our games now.
Yeah.
Second of all, we have to do so much work behind the scenes to clear things with certain streamers and stuff and YouTube channels.
Yeah. No, it's bad. I saw a post.
I like how you're still getting away with it scot-free.
Well, that's the thing.
When you don't care.
None of this applies to you if you don't do any archives at all.
Yeah.
You can play as much music as, until they have live DMCA, which I think they'll probably drop at any point. But, it still only affects archives.
Yeah.
But I saw a post, I don't know if it was a joke or not, but it was someone saying they got a DMCA strike because they were doing a cooking stream and turned on their Blender, and Twitch said it was a Skrillex song. I don't know if it's true or not. But people are getting, like, dinged for, like, literal just, like, sound effects. Like,
yeah.
Birds chirping and shit. Like, oh, that's...
Yeah, Shutterstock owns that sound of a bird.
Yeah.
Well, that was... Remember when that happened on... it was, like, YouTube, where vloggers would, like, walk by, a Buffalo Wild Wings that would be playing, like, mm-hmm. some song and be like, oh, well, your whole channel's demonetized.
Sorry. Now. Toby Keith now owns all of your content.
Toby Keith's I Love This YouTube channel. Well, look out. Be careful. Delete everything that you love.
Yeah.
Back it up if you want.
Yeah. 7 test positive for COVID-19 on first Caribbean cruise since March.
Who could have seen this coming?
And this is what we talked about this last week. This is one of those test cruises. There's more staff on this cruise than actual.
Beta cruise.
Yeah, it's like there's like 50 passengers and 60 crew members, and it's literally just a test to like see if any of this is possible. And the very first test cruise there's an outbreak immediately. Like within the first day or two.
Of course.
It's just spreading around the cruise.
Have you seen the map from the University of Georgia where you can like look at your county and see how the likelihood of being near someone has COVID? You shouldn't, because it's terrifying.
If
you go to a grocery store, someone in that grocery store while you're in it has COVID. And in a lot of places, it's like, I think it was Kansas. If you go into any area with more than 10 people, you have a 90% chance of experiencing someone with COVID.
Yeah, so, a lot of the states in, like, the plains, like, central Midwest area, like, I was, like, one of the Dakotas I was looking at, and it was, like, 10% of the entire population has had COVID at one point.
Yeah.
Like, that's ridiculous.
Yeah.
And it's just, that's probably going to go up.
Oh, yeah, no, yeah. Thanksgiving's coming up. Christmas is coming up.
We can't let the virus win by stopping us from celebrating the holidays because
mm-hmm.
we anthropomorphize this virus. I saw another.
I can't wait to see Tucker Carlson confusingly look at the camera and blame COVID for the war on Christmas this year.
Mm-hmm.
And somehow Joe Biden's fault because of COVID or whatever. Like, but whatever. He'd be like, oh, now we can't see our families because of some virus.
Yeah. And final headline, suspended NASCAR driver says he didn't intentionally draw a swastika on his toaster strudel.
Oops. I was trying to draw a house, and I just did it in a very specific pattern.
Yeah, I find it incredibly, if you look at the swastika strudel, it's hard to really believe this was an accident. He said, I was putting the icing on the strudel, and I wasn't paying attention, I was in a hurry, and what do you know? Perfect swastika. And also, I didn't mean to post that to my main Snapchat, I meant to just send it to my friends on Snapchat. as
because they love toaster strudels.
Yeah. Sorry, I don't buy it. Yeah. But if it's true, it is funny. But it's not.
It would have been like even funnier. It was like, yeah, it was an accident. I didn't mean to do the swastika. Also, I was hacked.
Yeah. Also, did you know swastika is a symbol of peace in a lot of cultures?
Yeah, that's the next step.
All the, just, you know, pick and choose, whatever. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All those.
Yeah. It's Mad Libs for apologies. Mm-hmm. All right, well, that's it for Weekly Weird News this week. We'll be back next week with more videos. Please stay tuned. Hit the subscribe button if you haven't done it already, and we'll watch our other videos. We got, if you want to know what the inside of Quibi looks like and looked like in the last couple of months and weeks there, literally the quote is, it was pure chaos.
Yeah, pure chaos.
So check out that episode of News Dump. Check out the latest Tech News Day, and we'll see you soon for some more videos.
Thank you for your service.
Bye.